you have any research, or are you aware of any research on cost analysis on what we call
on interfacing devices?
Yeah.
There is a little bit. Ms. Mormon has done some research and has some preliminary numbers. Not a lot has been done yet because folks are still just trying to figure out what they're doing. But she presented at the AAMI conference, and Dustin could probably find that presentation from the 2011 conference and talk to Patrick and maybe post that on your, somehow get a link or something.
Well, it sounds like I have the right person in my corner to persuade Patrick to let us do that.
We'll have to go talk to Mr. Denigro. But yeah, we'll see what we can do.
And also, do you see organizations like JACO pushing harder on this? From my opinion, JACO to be the one that pushes through, like they did with the needle sticks or the IV pumps, then,
right.
The guys get, worried.
No, you've got a very good point, and it goes back to hospitals get the heebie-jeebies about Joint Commission because if they don't have the Joint Commission accreditation or whoever their accrediting body is, if they don't get that accreditation, then the government doesn't pay them for anything. They don't get Medicare, Medicaid contracts. So you're absolutely right. That increases the level of urgency. Will Joint Commission specifically around interoperability or interfacing? Probably not. I'm going to speculate, and this is just me speculating, that it's going to come in through more of a backdoor, side door, as we're talking about quality and process on the clinical side of those accreditation processes. How patients are cared for in the nursing environment, the processes they use, the protocols they use, alarm management. Which is really, alarm management is truly a clinical protocol-driven concept. We just support it with technology. We give them the tools to deploy it. But what we see time and time again is we put the technology in there and all we're doing is automating a broken system. Okay? So I see the Joint Commission potentially pushing nursing, the clinician side, to improve their protocols and their clinical performance. And then we, with the technology, have to come in to support that. So sort of a backdoor.
But what you're saying is this going to save money at least? Because it's not going
not
to
in the short money. Term. Not in the short term. This is expensive stuff.
Yeah,
this
is to make money. They don't want to hear anything.
Yeah. Well, and I think it goes back to managing your technology, managing that entire life cycle, and understanding what technologies you're buying, why you're buying them, when you're buying them. Because the interfacing is not going to be inexpensive. There is a pretty significant outlay of cash up front. Long term, are we going to save money because the documentation is improved? We are already seeing, and I can't cite the exact studies, but there is already seeing an improvement in the quality of documentation. All of us, when we're typing or writing, we transpose numbers, we transpose letters. It's just the way it is. If it's feeding through, you increase the quality, the accuracy, of the data. So I think in time we'll see, now I don't have as many patients readmitted for the same thing because I'm treating them appropriately with the appropriate data earlier in the process. This is a long-term vision, but we got short-term things we got to do right now. The wave is on us.
You better get more cooperation from the nonprofits than you do for the for-profit. Take a moment.
It's hard to say. It's really hard to say because, I think it depends, again, it depends on senior leadership and where's their vision? Is it short term, what's my next quarterly earnings? And you hear those discussions in nonprofits as much as you do in for-profits. Or am I looking at the long term in terms of where do I need to be delivering on my mission, whether it's to make money or not make money. They all have a community. They have a customer base.
I will say something to that. About a previous employer, I worked for the Department of Veterans Affairs, and they would spend the money if it would improve patient care. And they're on a essentially fixed budget, fixed by Congress. The only revenue they really bring in is from veterans associations brotherhoods, if you will, that will donate TVs or something like that, and from being able to bill if somebody has some other secondary or primary insurance, I should say. But they would do the things, and I was very pleased to see that, but they would either do the things, spend the money, or push the vendors to comply with the standards that are out there, right? Or even the recommended standards, so that they have a long-term goal for integrating devices and integrating the information into the EMR. So,
and that's really, that, I mean, that's a real statement of culture. You know, that's the culture for the VA system. We're going to take care of our vets. Whatever it takes, we're going to take care of our veterans. Or in the military, we're going to take care of our active duty people. You know, it's very focused on the patient. And I think the organizations that adopt that philosophy, we're very focused on the patients, and the quality that we deliver will come out sort of the other end of this very dark tunnel that we're in. But it's going to be a journey. I think those that worry about the nickels and dimes of today, they're going to struggle. I liken it to what we have to do as individuals in our home, you know? My car. Do I change the oil? And do I have the tune-ups done? And do I take care of it? Or do I wait till the thing, you know, dies in the middle of the interstate and I have to be towed and have, you know, the entire transmission and you know, whatever. Pay me now, you pay me later. Kudos or whatever I have to give to Midas for their jingle.
But at the same time, we have to take care of the motor and the wheel and the brake, but if the radio breaks.
Right.
That one, right?
That's managing your technology, though. Yeah. Absolutely.
And at the beginning of your speech, you kept saying how budgets are going to get, cut.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know where we're going right now. There's a lot of turbulence.
Right. But I think what we have to do is we have to change our mentality that we can't. It's not excusable for a patient to get worse in the hospital because we didn't deliver care appropriately. We didn't. We have beds that new mattresses haven't been purchased in 10 years. We have beds that don't work that we're still putting people on. We still have infusion pumps that will routinely free flow.
And I agree that